Hey, it works. I just had a couple of Mega Drive games that didn't work. Bit of a shame and quite a surprise because Mega Drive game on an emulator not working. Weird. That I can understand that with the Amiga because that's a pain to get up and running, but Mega Drive. Anyway, off on a tangent. Body counts in the house on the Sega Mega Drive. Body counts on the Sega Mega Drive. Ooh, gone options while we're here. Because I like that picture in the background. Normal. Fire missile. I didn't take any of that in. We'll work it out. There's only two buttons. How hard can it be? Then again, Speedball 2 springs to mind. Okay. One player. Ooh. Nice. Dingy digitized photo of a Sega Mega Drive pad. Oh, it's one of them. Oh, I remember this. Beautiful. I've just used all my missiles up. That was stupid. Okay. B button is not like on the Amiga. It doesn't constitute the fire button. I did just totally blow up a load of baddies though in one go. That was cool. Okay, this is ace. I remember this with a light gun or something. I didn't realise you could even play it with a pad. I'm guessing the gameplay's been slowed down drastically per play with a pad. It's a shame I've just used all the bombs up. What I wouldn't give now to just stick a grenade in the middle of them. But hey, we're done. Ooh, green star. Oh, missed it. Oh, well. Some kind of flask in there. Oh, hello. Yeah. See, I remember seeing this with a light gun and really wanting to play it. And being a bit gutted that it was a light gun only game. But, hey, it's a pad game. I'm probably getting my rear end handed to me. Then again, I'm guessing they've made this game much simpler for pad controls. You know what? I'm getting nowhere killing them. Where's my target gone? There it is. Alright, the target gets a bit lost in the details of the level. I'd love a bomb. Oh, wow, I've got a bomb! I had a bomb! I got more bombs. I've got 9 bombs. Well, grenades. I'm going to use another one. Have that, my friend. And that. Oh, I see. We're just getting the same baddies over and over until what? Until I kill a certain amount of them. Because, you know, I can do this. Ooh, this. This. Almost all day. Get the bullets. Did I get it? No, it's Beast Busters, isn't it? It is hard to be. Die, evil jetpack man. Yeah, I just threw grenade at him. Threw grenade after grenade at the situation. Beast Busters. No, don't get me wrong, I love Beast Busters. I'm saying that a lot, don't get me wrong. I noticed that in my videos. I don't normally say that in real life. I think what I'm trying to say is, I love Beast Busters even though it's pretty loathable. Most people would loathe it, and I actually love it. I think because it's got that sort of zombie thing, and it's got a little feeling of the atmosphere of Dawn of the Dead to it. Although the zombies are obviously ridiculous. But it does have that kind of Romero feel before the Romero feel was a thing. You know, before Resident Evil triggered off zombie game after zombie game after zombie game after zombie game. And even I got a bit tired of zombies when The Walking Dead kind of went to its 4th, 5th series. And I am like, well, was at one point the biggest zombie fan you could ever hope to meet. To the point where I did make a zombie film when I was at university. That was so bad it was good. You will never see that film. You will never see that film. I'm out of ammo. But what do you do now? I see. Am I getting like snippets of bullets? Oh, am I out of ammo? Just suddenly making a different noise. I want to kill the big spider beast. I'm in trouble. I'm not looking at my health, but I've just got this feeling I'm in trouble. Oh, Shadow of the Beast dude, what's his name? Abaron. Abagabeni. He does look like him. Anyway, off on a zombie tangent. Let's return from that particular dark alleyway. Say ammo low, it did say ammo low. I'm guessing with this game you don't want to just hold down the fire button there. Tempting as it is, he does look like Shadow of the Beast guy. I'm in trouble here, and I've got 2 grenades and low ammo and low health. Oh well, you know, throw everything I've got. Yeah, because look at me bullets, I've got like 1 bullet at a time coming out. I'm never going to get a bullet, a falling bullet with 1 bullet every second. Oh, doesn't this suck the fat one? Look, it's really trying to help me as well. It's giving me loads of falling. Yes, bullets, let's go. Did that tickle, does it? Oh, forget it. I want the bullets. He's like laughing at me when I shoot him. Like the bullets are tickling his little hide. Oh no, these are nasty. I've got 7 grenades. Come on, grenades. Take them out. I think I've just shot them all at the scaffold in front of them. Come on, at least take one out. I need to take one out. Oh yeah, there we go. That's the one. I suddenly I just found a better technique. I am flailing all over the place, even though I'm playing the sound deep. I think what it is, oops, sorry, that was me knocking the microphone about a bit in the excitement. I think what it is, oof, that was me bombed. The target doesn't have a set trajectory. Oh, yeah, more. That was abrupt, wasn't it? Oh, look at him. I'm so glad I asked for more. Let's go. Have some grenades in your little robot system. It doesn't have a set trajectory. It speeds up. So it starts slow. Oh, no, a lot of bombs. It starts slow and it gets faster. That makes sense. Like, that. It's hard to explain. It's not hard to explain. You just got to trust me on this. It starts slow and gets faster. I'm just going to take out his guns. Minimal movement. Oh, okay. Maybe his face as well. Am I even hitting him? I swear it warns me my ammo's low and I'm not doing any damage. See what I mean? So, if you're holding down the movement and you change direction, it keeps the high speed that it's picked up. Wow. Bum kicked. Full credit in one. Okay, well, let's just grenade him. Oh, those grenades are rubbish. I want those ones that go sideways. Yeah, it just, and you end up sort of swirling around in circles very fast, trying to pick up the bullets. Like, I didn't realise I was over screen right then for like 2-3 seconds. Oh, 2 seconds, if that. But it felt like a lot longer. This guy pummeling bullets into you. I'm getting his guns there, aren't I? I saw bits fall off. What I loved about this game, when I was playing it, back to a tangent I left earlier, was the globule-y droplets of blood when you kill baddies. I thought that was stylistically very beautiful. Again, more grenades. If I get where the gun's gonna go, there, grenade. Oh, I'm out of grenades. Maybe. There's gotta be a tactic here I'm not employing. He just feels like he's not taking any damage. Would I do more damage by doing that as gun arms as he lands on me? No, I don't think so. What about his face? What about... I'm looking for bits. Yeah, that's it. Where the little grey metal bars and pieces of shrapnel fly off him. I've got to feel my boss to die. Oh, yeah, that's worked. Okay, now we'll get the other gun. Ah, I'm on target, though. This is working. Stay on target. Stay on target. I've just been listening to the Han Solo stories. You know, they did like 3 novels, a trilogy of Han Solo stories. I've just been listening to them on Audible. Other book sites are probably available. Very cool. I think the guy who reads them sounds like Han Solo, which is the charm, really. And really does it for me. The stories feel abridged, and I think they are. But it's good. It's good. It tells you like all his life up to the point where the Star Wars film starts. That's fun. I like it. I'm pretty sure it's official as well, you know. I was telling me this about it. She said, did George Lucas write it? I'm like, well, probably not, but would it matter if he did? Looking at episodes 1 to 3, you know, there's hardly consistency with 4 to 6, was there? Anyway, tangents today. Good lord. Yeah, this is working. Check out the little grey bits flying off him. And there's dead guns. Where are those missiles going up? Maybe I should be focusing on those. What do you think? Answers on a postcard. This is probably not the best way to kill him. You probably just need to be better at following him. That's still taking him out. He's got another gun behind the gun. Who would have thunk it? Oh, this is harsh, man. This is a harsh boss. I can see he's clearly a level boss. He's very pretty in the way he's drawn. I'm not sure about his animation. It sucks. There is no animation. Literally no animation. And I'm not sure about the technique I'm employing to kill him. Or that I'm encouraged to employ to kill him. I don't think following him around with the pad is going to do me any better than this approach. I'm going to take all those bombs, man. Proper wrecking. Those big missile-y things. Come on, sort of explode. Yes! Uh-oh. We're in trouble, aren't we? Yeah, those missiles are coming out of there. I'm never going to beat them. But look how close I got. Look how close I got, guys. Come on. Explode. Nah, it's not. I reckon that arm's not even near to exploding. What do you reckon? Look at the energy, man. 15 ammo. And a tiny little heart. I'm so dead. Oh, Come on, blow up now. Oh, come on, Alan. Blow up now. Look how close this is.
Dirty girl, me.
And his little mates then. Any bad looks at it. Get your face. The artwork's ace, isn't it? Love it. Love that game. It's great. Alright, limited by the fact that you are playing a gun game on a pad. But, you know. It's still good and very pretty. And I'm really glad I actually got to play body count with a pad. At all, really, because I thought, you know, it'd be a gun and that would be that. Awesome. It might be the new version I'm thinking of there. Awesome. Really enjoyed that. Body count on the Sega Mega Drive. Flawed, but beautiful and very good. So what?